But I am pleased to be at this launch of the Start Them Early program, STEP. This project is a product of the type of innovative thinking that ensures that young people learn agribusiness in theory and practice right from secondary school. Early 80s, I was at Bishop Phillips Academy, Woro, Ibadan, 1980 to 1985, and we had a school farm. There was also a fish pond behind the school, but all of those are gone now. So this is a wake-up call for us. In the 80s to early 90s, we had the Young Farmers Club in schools all over our state. There was also the School to Land program. I believe that must have been around 84 in River State. I watched it myself on NTA, you know, the product of that School to Land program. These programs helped to stir the interest of some youths towards agriculture. And I must say that some people who have grown to become farmers today developed their interest in agriculture because of those initiatives. So, it is time to borrow a leaf out of the 80s book and bring back this initiative. This pilot program will expose young minds to careers in agriculture that they never knew existed, just like a young man said. He thought agriculture was a hardship posting, but both himself and even the young girls among them, they are using the mechanized instrument very well, and they are seeing productivity, you know, coming to life. So apart from the exposure to careers in agriculture, they will also be given the needed direction to pursue these careers. I am particularly thrilled because they will not only be learning agriculture in the classroom, they have a school farm right behind them. Positive peer pressure in form of social clubs will be used to reinforce their classroom training. And then they will get practical entrepreneurial training in the business of agriculture. One of the challenges that agribusiness is facing is that in most parts of Africa, when we talk about agriculture, the picture that comes to the mind is not a young man sitting in his office looking at a computer. It is an older man or woman, you know, with a back bent, tilling the soil with a hoe or attacking weeds with a cutlass. And this is why initiatives such as STEP are very, very important. I've seen pictures of you know, the computers in there. I've gone around, and I'm sure the students here, they've also seen, and most of them will be shocked that they won't want to even go to the cities. And that is what we are trying to do, to stem rural urban migration. So STEP is really is hard, you know, to attack that. And so I'm delighted that we're flagging up this program in Nigeria here at Fashola Grammar School in Oyo State. And I know the DG's connection to Fashola. So I know that there are still many goodies coming to Fashola, you know, through the DG. It's here. The truth is, what we set before young people as goals is what they will pursue. When our parents told us to be doctors, lawyers, engineers, and architects, we followed that path. I remember once I told my father that I would love to be a footballer. I received the beating of my life that day. He said, well, later we got a compromise. He said, okay, even if you want to be a footballer, you first of all be an engineer or a doctor or a lawyer, then you can be an engineer. And he cited Segun Odegbami at that time. I said, look, Segun Odegbami plays football, but I think he was an engineering student at the Polytechnic of Ibadan at that time. So we know that you will follow the path that we set for these young ones. The school system also emphasizes those professions. It is now time to diversify. It is time to start teaching our children the business of agriculture. And this ties up nicely with our plans here in Oyo State to leverage on agriculture to grow our economy. We have created the Oyo State Agribusiness Development Agency. Through this agency, we have recently launched the Youth in Agribusiness Tomato Project targeted at youth in Awe, here in Oyo, Igbora in Ibarapa, and Tede in Okiogun zones. We're also kickstarting the farm estates in Akufo and Iruwa. All this will open up Oyo State to direct investment, both foreign and local, into agriculture. We remain steadfast in our resolve to grow our economy through agribusiness. So let me use this opportunity to once more call on all who are interested in doing, in all those who are interested in agriculture as a business. We want to hear from you. We want to work with you. Our administration remains open to ideas that will change the perception of our young ones towards agriculture. I also want to thank the International Institute of Tropical Agriculture under the leadership of Dr. Saginga for your contribution to agriculture in Oyo State, development of agriculture, but the overall development of the state, because we cannot divorce your efforts. You know, here is Stardom Heli, but you've gone ahead to renovate the classrooms, to put in a new laboratory in here. So we are grateful to the management of IITA, and we hope to even do more together. This project wouldn't have been possible without your vision. So this is a laudable project which is being flagged off today. I've also listened to some of the people that spoke earlier. The principal mentioned security in schools, and then the gentleman from IITA mentioned that IITA has gone ahead to fill the gap for a short while, and it's not a problem for this school alone. When we opened the schools and then went for inspection of some schools within Ibadan, we saw the issues with security in those schools, because in some schools they've carted away their chairs, the books. So now talk about putting high-valued items like computers, then this will easily attract the not too good people in our society. So it's a challenge that I've discussed with the Commissioner for Education, and it has to be solved, not only for Fashola Grammar School, but for most of our schools in Oyo State. And while I was talking with the DGITA, I asked, so how much did all of this even, how much did it cost? And he gave me the figure, and I said to myself that thank God we have an MOU. So we have the channel, you know, to really walk through, you know, to have this in most parts of your state. So what I will do when we leave here is that I'll provide a small budget within the 2020 budget in Oyo State for IITA and our ministry, Ministry of Education, and also OISTADA, to locate facilities like this within the other six geopolitical zones in Oyo State. So this budget will utilize our MOU to do the survey. And once we're able to do the survey, and I also asked the DG, how long did it take, you know, for all of this to happen? He said he visited in 2018. So it took roughly a year, really, because if we take COVID-19 out of the equation, this will have actually been commissioned much, much earlier in the year. So we will finish the survey this year, and if we even move really fast, we may be able to do one or two even before this year runs out. But one thing that is sure, I will take ownership of this project, and the rest of the schools will come in under the 2021 budget. So I'm happy to tell you that this project, which is starting in Fashola Grammar School, will be extended to other areas of Oyo State. And that soon, through this project, we will have a new generation of agropreneurs in Oyo State. Because even though experts are not agreed on whether or not agriculture is the best catalyst for the growth of the economy, they are agreed that any nation or people that do not have food security will fail on other metrics of nationhood. So once again, Baba ati mama wa ni Fashola community. Mo dupe lowo yin pe e fowo sowopo pelu ijoba pelu ITA. Mo ri pe ona ta gunde bi ona ye o da ka ba so ikeji ni. Well, we've written a letter to the, it's a federal road from Oyo, from that junction, all the way to Shaki, is a federal road. But we've written to the federal government, to the Honorable Minister for Works, to allow Oyo State to fix this road. So as soon as we have the approval from them, we will fix the road. Yes, some people will come back and say to us that why are we fixing federal roads? On Tuesday, the State Executive Council approved for us to float a bond. And we said part of the bond will be utilized to expand the Ibadan airport and allow it to become a truly international airport, such that flights can come in to Ibadan airport from outside of the country. But as I was coming here, I was reading in the newspaper, and somebody that should even know a lot better said, the airport is the federal government airport, and that is adjusted now for that Christmas that will be fixing the airport. And my question is, people flying through the airport to Ibadan, are they adjusted people or not? Are they federal people? If we stop our people from driving all the way to Lagos to fly out of the country, and we can have Dr. Sagiga fly from outside of the country to Ibadan, will it not improve our economy? Yes. So whether they will tell us we have had a Christmas or not, when we fix that road, Fashola people will be able to go to Oyo and also to Ibadan with less hassles. Our Fashola people, federal people, they are Oyo State people. So, as soon as we have that approval, work will commence and it will go all the way from Oyo to Saki, from Oyo to Isheyi will be completely rebuilt. I've seen the bridge over the Ogu River. It is a bridge in the 50s. So it will be expanded and it will be able to take trailers, because they will be coming here to take farm produce to the market. And from Isheyi to Saki, we'll rehabilitate, because that portion is still fairly good. But from Isheyi to Oyo through Fashola, anything short of rebuilding it completely will not give us the desired result. So when next they come to you and say Oyo State is Father Christmas, yes, tell them we're Father Christmas for Oyo State people, for Fashola people. So once again, Aoto Mojo, more successful. So I once again thank you for having me, and God bless you all.
Thank you, Your Excellency.